hope you're having a good day. So here we are, it's Monday. I am really excited because everything's here, everything's ready. I'm ready to start stitching. Oh, it's gotten really warm. So you can see now, first, let me tell you the really exciting part. So these are the threads that I'll be using for our Bayeux tapestry Monty Python mashup. Here's all the colors, trying to get everything in the shot here. And let me tell you why this is really cool, okay? All of these threads are their wool, they're hand dyed, and they're beautiful. And they're by the same company that I've always used for my embroidery kits, which is called Renaissance Dyeing. And they're located in the south of France. And as soon as I held their threads in my hands, I knew this was it. I knew this is the what I wanted to use for making my medieval embroidery kits. So when I was working on this project at the beginning of last week, I sent an email to Andy, who is the person behind Renaissance Dyeing, and I told her, hey, I'm doing this project, it's a mashup, etc., etc. Hey Sarah, I'm just talking about this. You are going to love this story, okay? So these are all my hand-dyed yarns, right? They are made by Renaissance Dyeing. It's a company that's located in the south of France. And so when I was getting ready for this project, I sent a message to Andy, who is the person behind Renaissance Dyeing, and I said, I'm doing this project. It's a mashup with the Bayeux tapestry and Monty Python, and what colors did she think I should use? Well, what she said was, oh, well, when the artist did the reconstruction on the Bayeux tapestry 20 years ago, she used these our threads. Here's the colors that she used. And I went, I was so surprised. So yes, these are the exact same colors and threads that were used on the reconstruction of the last panel of the Bayeux tapestry, the real Bayeux tapestry. So I'm really, really, really excited. Not this color. There's a different color. There's a different red shade that was used, but that's okay. I told her I'm not looking for an exact replica. It's not what I'm going for. It's just meant to be something fun. But if I can, you know, do it kind of close anyway, why not do it that way? So yeah, that's what we're doing. So I've got all the threads. Some of them you can see I already had. They're already a little bit used up, but that's okay. That's fine. If I need more, I know where to get them. So got the threads. In fact, I need to make myself, I might do this after our stream today, actually, is I need to crochet up a little basket or something to carry these around. So I've got my colors. Last night I got the fabric pretty much done. I basically destroyed a rug in my house doing this fabric. I should not have ironed on a synthetic rug. There's a tip for you. But it was so big, I didn't want to iron directly on our floor. That's just how it is. I've sewn down the side so I don't have to worry about the edges, but look at this monster. Let's see how big it is. on the camera. He's a big boy. And there we go. So I am going to start right smack in the middle, as you always should with embroidery. Start in the middle and work your way out. I'm going to start with the fortress in the middle. So first I'm going to go ahead and... lost my page there. There you are. I'm going to go ahead. I brought my two different sized hoops. I don't know which one I'm going to... I'll probably use the smaller one for when I start working on the border. But for the bigger parts in the middle, I think it'll be better to have a bigger one. So what I'm going to do... I'll go ahead and do this part... first, and then what I'm gonna do is go ahead and I'm gonna roll up the sides. I've actually never done an embroidery this big. I know that in and of itself is not that unusual, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to just sort of pin down. I'm using, yeah, you could see there on the camera. I'm just going to, do a little clippy action. So I don't have to fight so much with the edges. And I do, since most of the elements, the vast majority of the elements come from the Bayeux tapestry, I am using that for reference so I can have an idea of colors and stuff. I don't have to do it that way, but might as well, right? So what I'm gonna start with is this area up here. So I'm gonna go ahead and do the outlines in red. It looks like the whole thing, except for this interior, blah, 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 the arcade part is gonna be in red. So I'm gonna go ahead and do the outline first and we'll start with that. So that's what's going on. Oh, I forgot my scissors. Ugh. I forgot my scissors and I forgot my ruler. I knew I was forgetting something. It's Monday, man. Go ahead and pull out this. Right, I am going to go grab a ruler and then we're going to start stitching. Be right back. Don't fall down. Oh. See, I've got too many things up here. There we go. All right, be right back. Okay, I got you and I got you. I'm also gonna be writing down how much of each color I'm using because I just like to know that, and you know, I just like to know. That way I can kind of count up. Well, oh, come on, Monday, work with me. You can't even see what I'm doing right now. I'm trying to thread my needle. There we go. I have had such a Monday today. Nothing really terrible, just everything that could go wrong. Okay. See you in a little bit, I hope. I'll cross my fingers. So if you're curious about stitches, the outlines are all pretty much done in, okay, Fingers are crossed. Or are you already settled in the sewing room? Because that was fast. There's only a few stitches that are used in the Bayeux tapestry. This is stem stitch. I do a very weird stem stitch. Part of it's because I'm left-handed, but also part of it is I like to be a little bit more precise about where I'm stitching. And this gives me a little bit more control than the typical way of doing it. Also, I don't see exactly where my line is here. Some of the transfer didn't go very, very well. Whoops. Which is fine. So yeah, mostly stem stitch for the outlines. And then the couching stitch for the interiors, which has come to be known today as the Bayeux stitch. Work with me now. You're not working with me. A little better. Right, where am I? Now, I was wondering, when I look at this, this isn't the best picture, obviously, it's blown up to oblivion, but I've been trying to work out if they stitched this line or if they stitched each individual section. And I think it's kind of mixed between the two. So what I'm gonna do is go ahead and do big loops and then go back and just do little curves. So I'll do a big loop and then kind of fill that out. it. One thread down. Many, many, many to go. Thank you. are you? This is embroidery. How are you today, Times? Thank you. fell down. It fell down. Thank you. It's going to be slow going, though. Sarah, I was thinking of you this morning. I went out this morning in my mask that I made. It's the first time I've worn it out. And I was really annoyed. I had to take it back off because the cord that I bought to tie it is polyester and it won't stay closed. I should have gotten cotton and I didn't. And it's basically, well, the cord is basically useless. I'm really annoyed. I've got to go back to work next week, and they've asked me to bring a mask if I have one, but they said they do have some, so. I don't have any elastic. And it, believe it or not, elastic is really hard to find right now. But I think I have, if I can't find elastic. Yeah, that's what I wanted to use. But none of my shoelaces, I have shoelaces at home, but they're too short. And so I went online to try and find longer ones to buy. And they were really expensive because apparently that's, it's the fashion again, you know, to wear different colored shoelaces and stuff. I'll figure something out. I'm just real annoyed about it. But it looks like we're more and more, they're trying to get us really back to normal. Looks like my son's gonna go back to school in a couple of weeks, in the first week of June. And Stefan's there today. He's gone today. will. I don't want to be back in the world, but I think they're kind of forcing us into it. I took the bus today, too. You know what? Yes, I do. Duh. I even have cotton yarn. You know what else is thick? Of course I can use yarn. Why didn't I think of that? Ding-a-ling. I think I've still got some old peaches and cream lying around I could use. Yeah. I just think, why did I not think of that before? I did. I was waiting for you to come along and tell me what to do. Thank God you were here. The thing is, the worst part. Okay, I've been going out on walks because I needed to, I do too. It's so good. In fact, I was going to make a little crochet basket for the yarns that I'm using for this project. Because I usually group all my yarns together by color, but since it's all mixed up, I just thought, oh, I'll just make a little basket. And that's perfect for that kind of stuff. I love it. But when I go out on walks, I don't wear a mask because they say if you're out in nature and you're really keeping a good distance from people, you should be okay. So since I have asthma, having a mask, you know, on my face makes it that much harder to, you know, walk at a decent pace. So I took the bus this morning to run my errands, and that was weird. That was a weird experience, but I'm going to have to take the bus if I go to work because, even though I'm only working one day a week, it's a day that Stefan's working too. So, and it's only for a couple hours anyway. It's really hard to get peaches and cream here, which stinks. It's hard to get any yarn. I don't know why, but it's really hard to get yarn that's not acrylic here. It's really frustrating. And Stefan always laughs at me when I go home to the States. And I come home with half my suitcase is yarn. But if I want to get some, just for like little projects around the house or cat toys or whatever. Yeah, actually that is one thing. They've been good about having hand sanitizer everywhere. The hand sanitizer? I think so. Actually, we can get it. Pretty easily now. We can get it in. What we can't get are masks. If you don't make your own right now, they're just having a really hard time keeping masks in stock everywhere. As soon as a store says they have masks, they're gone. So that's making it really frustrating too. But a lot of, like, I went to the grocery store this morning. It's the first time I've been in a grocery store in 3 months. That was crazy. But they actually have hand sanitizer. Oh, do they carry peaches and cream? I don't know. I'm going to look because I do, sometimes I do find American things on Amazon on the French website and I can get it, but once upon a time, one of my business projects back in the day was to actually sell it in France. and have my own website for it, and we were gonna do it, and a bunch of stuff happened, and I went in a different direction. What's happening here? Is that... Oh, I think it's... Hold on, I need to look at my... Oh, I think that's two different ones. Yeah, I see. Okay. All right. But I had told my husband that if the company that I give English classes for calls me, that I would only give classes online. But the boss dude is actually in his 70s. He's well past the age of retirement. And I know that he was very, very concerned about this when this everything started happening in March. So I feel pretty confident that if he feels comfortable enough, and it also, I have to say, his business is located in his house. It's his business, and then there's an apartment behind it. So if he feels comfortable enough bringing people into his house, I guess I can feel comfortable enough going. Hmm. Is it just the music or is it me blabbing too? Well, good. Not that I'm saying anything. Come on, connection. Thank you. Well, I do think I'm at least gonna get this roof outlined today. Oops. No oopses, please. Not in a comfortable chair, but that's all right. One, two, three. Okay. Thank you. see you later. Thank you for coming and spending some time with me, Sarah. I love you. See you soon. No knots, please. See you. Be gone. Or don't. Don't make me flip you over. Whoops. Woohoo, the roof is done. Ugh. Break time. Excellent. Onwards, 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 yes. Let's go. All right, my friends, I am gonna stop here for today. Looks like tomorrow I'll be able to get started on filling in that rooftop. That'll be fun. It'll change. Yeah. So, if you're watching on YouTube, thank you, first of all. Thanks for the likes. Thanks for the subscribes. I really appreciate it. If you have any questions about what I'm working on, you can leave them down in the comments below, or you can join me on Twitch live Monday through Friday, 3 p.m. Paris time, 9 a.m. Eastern Standard. And I guess that's it for today. Have a great day, and I'll be back here tomorrow. Thanks. See you soon. Bye.